last two, Trichomonas and malaria. Trichomonas can actually be transmitted sexually. It is Trichomonas vaginalis. So very often it can be an STD. And when we were going through our STD PowerPoint, I skipped past this one. You may or may not remember. And I said, we'll get to it later. This one can be transmitted back and forth through sexual intercourse. So men can get it as well. It's transmitted back and forth through a protist that has a very strong flagella, which you know is the means by which they move. And as it swims through the urethra or the vaginal canal, it causes some very serious itching and burning. It can be treated. Trichomonas can be picked up, by the way, on toilet seats. This is a living protist, so it can live a little bit longer than bacteria can. I wouldn't think it would be able to live there for hours or days, but it is definitely something to be mindful of. If you know somebody that has got trichomoniasis or trichomonas, to be mindful not to use the bathroom after them. So it can be treated. It's typically you have to treat all partners, and it's typically treated with vaginal creams and what's called an antiflagellate. Some of these protists that move by means of flagella, if you take what's called an antiflagellate, it kills the flagella, they can't move, and therefore they can't infect. All right, malaria. Malaria is Plasmodium. Now, the reason there is no species name for Plasmodium is because it has a number of them. So when there's more than one, they just typically use the genus name. But Plasmodium has to be underlined as well. The vector is the Anopheles mosquito. That Anopheles, that A should be capitalized, and Anopheles should be underlined because it is a genus name for a specific mosquito that infects with malaria. It is only the female mosquito that bites. So we need to talk a little bit about how it works. When infected, the Anopheles mosquito will bite and inject at the same time as they're trying to suck your blood. They inject the Plasmodium into your bloodstream. This protist has two reproductive sites. The first reproductive site is in the liver. So when the mosquito injects the protist into your bloodstream, what will happen is it travels to your liver and then it reproduces for the first time. Now you've got a whole bunch in your liver. After 24 to 48 hours, it is going to leave and it is going to go infect the red blood cell. When it's in the red blood cell, it reproduces for the second time. 48 hours later, it leaves, it goes back into the liver, it reproduces again. Every time the protist is in the liver, you start to show symptoms. Symptoms are fever, chills, dementia, confusion, and ultimately death. Every time the cycle is in the liver and you're showing symptoms, it gets worse. So at first, you may feel like you have just a little flu, and then the second time it's in the liver and it's reproducing for the second reproductive cycle in the liver, you'll start to get chills, you get combative and paranoid, you think people are against you. A lot of times these people have to be strapped down. Now, there is a cure, and it is called quinine. That's Q-U-I-N-I-N-E. And it's a very old drug, and it has been helpful in killing the Plasmodium protist. People who travel to parts of the world that have this particular mosquito, we don't have it. They can take anti-malaria drugs, and they can take those prophylactically before they travel to those areas so that they don't get malaria. Once you get it, every 48 hours, your symptoms are going to get worse. So it's very helpful to know if you've been bit and to catch this in the early stages. Nowadays, quinine doesn't seem to be doing the trick, so they added a chlorine to it. So now the medication for treatment is called chloroquinine, and that's given currently to malaria patients to help with the symptoms and hopefully prevent death. It is one of those diseases that people who have sickle cell cannot be infected with, and we may have talked about this when we talked about sickle cell, because with the shape of the red blood cell being in the shape of a sickle, the plasmodium has a hard time infecting it, and that is one of the reproductive sites. So know that this protist has two reproductive cycles. First is in the liver. 48 hours later, it'll be in the red blood cell. 48 hours later, it's back in the liver. Another 48 hours back in the blood cell. Every 48 hours while it's in the liver, the symptoms get worse. They start off mild and they continue to get worse until ultimately, if not treated, there's death. And again, it's a specific mosquito, and in areas that have this, controlling the vector is helpful, but in areas, remote areas of Africa where this is a big deal and they have a lot of these mosquitoes, that just becomes hard. You know, anywhere where there's modern medicine and modern technology, it's helpful, but in some of these places, guys, they just don't have it. You know, they don't have the medical facilities that we have and the technology. So a lot of times people don't realize they've been bit by a mosquito until two or three cycles later. So if treated early, it can be cured. If not, it's almost uncertain death.